Guys, SD here. So, I'm making this video because I promised that I would put together a little short thing on how to get one of the delete boxes collapsed because it's not as easy as it looks, especially if you're afraid to cause any damage to it for, people who are collecting. So, this is one of the boxes that I got. This is Purple Storm Delete. Just comes like that. Yeah, it's a very, very nice box. Very nice box. I apologize for the lighting. It's like bullshit. It's hot as hell in here. And okay, so I open the lid. Doop doop doo. Take your tub out. As you can see, the tub itself, there's nothing special about it. So if you're trying to collect these, don't worry about having to get the tub too. This is especially helpful for traits, because as I discovered, sending things out of the US is like obnoxious as hell. So you definitely 100% do not want to have to send a full tub if you don't absolutely have to. Like, we're talking $50 American minimum, which I think is like, I don't even know how much that is in pounds. I'm sorry. But yeah, go do that math. It's not great, especially considering how cheap it is for you guys to send stuff to us. So, all right. So, if you can see into the box here, there we go. It's got like a little flower hinge on it on the inside. You can see it from the bottom here too. Part of the trick is that when you, let me see if I can get the lighting. When you are pressing in, those little notches want to catch on each other. So you have to like press in on the bottom. I gotta remember where my camera is. I keep pointing it at the light. You're pressing at the bottom, but at the same time, you're gonna reach inside and kind of try to maneuver the little flanges so they don't catch on each other. You are probably going to experience some amount of box degradation at this point. It's very upsetting. But I've not figured out a way to avoid that. There we go. All right. So as you can see, I got the box pulled apart. You can see kind of a tiny bit of there's a little tiny, tiny crease in this flange here. I don't know if you can really tell, but yeah. So then you come to the next tricky part. When you first go to squash it feels like it doesn't want to squash. Like, it really feels like it does not want to squash. So that is annoying as anything. But what's happening is on the inside, God, it's really hard to like point at this. Well, these flaps here are like catching, not only catching on each other, but they're catching against the sides of the box. So what you got to do is you got to reach in there as you are applying pressure to the sides of the box and kind of on both of those sides, lift them away from catching on the edges of the inside of the box. You just gradually squeeze as you're doing that, and eventually you get a nice flat box, just like that. Ta-da! Now, some people will, to like make it even smaller, they'll like fold back the lid here, or fold this here, fold this here. But I've opted not to do that. I just got like a 10 by 10 mailer. So it's going to be a little more expensive, but it's going to prevent degradation to the boxes that I send out. And I have purchased, I think I currently have two of them going out. One of them I have to get back with the person who wanted it. But I am willing to purchase more of these for anyone from the UK who really, really, really wants to get one of these boxes. You don't have to buy the tub too. You can do a straight up trade for a stealth box, or you can just pay for one of these and I'll figure out some sort of cost for that. Usually it's just shipping. But anyhow, so that's how you collapse the box. There's a lot of like finagling on the inside going on, and that's the main problem. So that's it. Until next time. SD out. Bye. I turn this off. Oh God, I haven't hooked up my thing yet.